Hey everyone, how's it going? So I know I've been talking to you about creating seamless stories for quite some time now, and I've been telling you that I've been working behind the scenes creating a course and software and different things like that. Well, the time has come for me to show you what I've been working on. Now, the best way for me to do that is just to simply tell you a story. And it all starts last year in December. I was going through my Instagram and I was watching people's stories, and there was this guy, and it all seemed to flow seamlessly. And I thought, that is awesome. I want to learn how to do that. Also, I found it really frustrating that I couldn't tell a long story very well because I had to keep starting and stopping my videos on Instagram stories and then trying to remember where I had stopped or left off, and if I had to do a retake. It just made it really frustrating and difficult. And from there, I went to my little study, my studio, and I figured out how it would work for me. And immediately, about three different people reached out to me and they said, "Hey, Martin, I've been watching your stories and I want to know how to do that." Now, I remember a guy by the name of Dan Miller saying that whenever he gets asked the same question by three different people, he immediately turns that into a product because he knows there's a lot more people out there with the same question. What I did is I asked my audience, I said, "How would you like to create a seamless story and then use that content all around the web, where you could zoom in and out and add music and different things like that and put it in your story? If you're interested, say I'm in." Well, I got like 30 responses to that almost overnight into my inbox in Instagram. People saying, "I'm in, I'm so in, tell me more, I want in." And that was exciting. I was like, wow, the potential for this is awesome. I'm going to create a training course and teach people how to make seamless stories. And then that's when the problem came up. You see, creating seamless stories on Instagram isn't a piece of cake. It's not as simple as it appears. It's actually quite a bit of work. It's a ton of work, actually. And it's complicated. And I knew that. And so, well, let me just tell you what all goes into it. First of all, you have to shoot the video, and then you have to upload it and get it on your computer. Then you have to edit it and add music and transitions and zoom in and out and do all the edits that you want to do to your video, to your story. Then you have to slice it up into 15-second segments. And then you have to save that file like 10 times or however many segments you have, and then remove everything but the segment you want to save and export that as its own video file. You have to do that for each segment that you want to upload. So if you have 10 segments, you do that 10 times, then you have to upload it to Google Drive. Then you have to go on your phone and download it to your phone from Google Drive, all those segments. Then you have to open Instagram, and then you have to upload each video in order on your Instagram story, and you have to remember which order they're all in. Now that I did all that. That was my method for creating seamless stories on Instagram. And it worked. And it's awesome. It does a great effect. But I knew that's going to be my hurdle. Furthermore, I knew that with software, everything I was doing, all of those steps could be done with just a touch of the button or just a few swipes of your finger. You could have all that done and create the video and upload it to Instagram in a matter of seconds. So I reached out to a friend of mine who is a code developing software engineering ninja. His code name is Brand On. And I said, "Hey, Brandon, what would it take to create software for me to be able to do this more easily?" And he's basically said, "Well, let me go see." And so he descended down into his basement lab and disappeared. And I never heard from him for the longest of time. So while I was waiting on him, I'm thinking, what am I going to do? Because I've been promising people this course that's going to train them how to make seamless stories. So I got to work. I created a sales funnel, website pages, wrote a bunch of web copy. I started shooting videos and putting them on there. And I invited a few of my friends to check out this web funnel and tell me what they thought. But over time, I just had this feeling that I couldn't shake. You know, the feedback that they gave me, as well as just this inner voice, I couldn't shake. I finally decided to take that training course and put it on the shelf and focus on this app that Brandon was working on. Finally, after what seemed like the longest time, Brandon finally ascended up out of the basement. The lights came on and he shouted, "It works! It works!" And it even saved the full length video as well. So I could use that on my YouTube and my Facebook channel. And furthermore, the self-facing side of my camera, when I recorded with it, it would read my t-shirt correctly or a book if I held it up. It didn't flip the text around. Awesome. That software worked, but Brandon's like, what are we gonna call this thing? Or what's it gonna look like on the inside? All this, user experience and stuff. So we talked about it and we finally agreed that we also all seem to wrestle with this concept or this thing of how to tell stories effectively. And so Brandon came up with the name Storio. And that's what we decided to name the app, was Storio. And with a focus on telling better stories. Because if you tell a story effectively, then you can effectively enlighten a soul. And if you can enlighten a soul, you will change the world. So that's kind of what our theme has now become, is how to tell better stories. And we have inserted into the app a daily story tip. So every time you open it, each day you get a new message teaching a new concept on how to tell better stories. Well, after version one was completed, the rough draft of the code was put into a nice package, a nice app. Brandon submitted it to Apple and it was approved for beta testing. So we invited a few friends to come in and start using this app, telling seamless stories and see how it worked. The next step was to take the app and submit it to the Apple App Store for sale. And it wasn't approved. No, seriously, it wasn't. But we found out that it has to do with just a word or two that we had in the description. So we removed those words and immediately it was approved by Apple and it's now available. The way that the app works is very, very simple. You can record from within the app using your selfie side of the camera or the other side of the camera. You can record your video and then, or you can upload a pre-recorded video as well. But then you just tap slice and intuitively thinks how many seconds to make the videos, and it slices them apart and saves them to your camera roll while saving a full length video as well. When that process gets done, it opens up a little pop-up that says open Instagram. So you click open Instagram and it opens your Instagram. Then all you have to do is go up to your story button up there in the upper left and click on it, swipe down with your finger, and there's all your clips down at the bottom in order, and you just upload them one at a time and you have a seamless story and it's a beautiful experience. We're going to continue to add updates and improvements to this app over time. The basics are there. It helps you tell better stories. It helps you tell seamless stories. The functionality is awesome as it is, and it's only going to improve over time. So our encouragement for you today is, if you want to tell better stories, if you want to enlighten souls and change the world, then go to the App Store and get Storio today.